surprised me. I was pleased by that. It made it easier.
Helen's body was found in a timber yard by police using dogs.
It was a rather forbidding place. It was very dark and wet. There was a little bit of street lighting, so there were dark shadows thrown onto these great stacks of wood. It was a horrible place to die. We were very keen, obviously, to see if we could find anything at all that the perpetrator might have left behind them. Because rough wood just picks up stuff, you know, it's splintery. But he wasn't leaving a lot of traces that we could actually analyse and compare. And certainly nothing that you could get a blood group out of.
I'm anxious to talk to a man who was said to be standing in the entrance to the woodyard at the end of Great Northern Street, opposite the toilets.
Whoever it was just so dangerous and so likely to kill again, and probably could be any day, could be quite quickly. And I think that added an extra impetus for George.
It was a lot for him. All this stress, all this pressure. Pressure from the press, pressure from the professionals. No officer had ever experienced that level of media coverage or pressure. I'm sure George took it personally. I would have taken it personally.
The whole area was being blitzed by cops knocking on doors with questionnaires, because where she was last seen was on quite